What's going on with our school food?
And are the way to finals changing? I'm Madison Calhoun.
And I'm Preston Jenkins.
Mustang TV News starts now.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Due to the pandemic and recent supply chain holdups, school food shortages have become ever more common across the country, with many schools asking kids to pack their own lunches.
Reporters Preston Jenkins and Atlee Stanley decided to go and find out how this is affecting McCracken County.
Recently, students all across the district have been experiencing the effects of a nationwide school food shortage, with food menus changing day by day and districts having to rely on local supermarkets for some food and supplies. This is a big issue. But one Sarah Hedges, the Director of Food Service for McCracken County Schools, knows plenty about. Sarah mentioned the reasons this shortage is happening.
My name is Sarah Jane Hedges, and I'm the Food Service Director for McCracken County, and I'm in charge of all 10 schools in our district. 40% of our goods that come in from around the world actually come into a port in Los Angeles. It's been kind of slowed down at this moment because of COVID restrictions and a lack of labor. We also have very specific needs for schools. We have to get whole grain things, low sodium things, things that are portioned correctly to give you the correct calorie count per age group.
Sarah also mentioned there not being enough truck drivers on the road to deliver the food. The Federal Motor Carrier Safety Administration announced a pilot program to try and lower the interstate truck driving age to 18 instead of 21. The program would have strict rules and conditions, but could be a new job opportunity right out of high school. At the end of September, the USDA announced additional funding assistance to help schools respond to supply chain disruptions. Sarah mentioned that this is helping them with the additional cost of food and paying for additional staff, and that the only thing we could do now is just be patient and give it time. With Mustang TV News, I'm Preston Jenkins.
And I'm Atlee Stanley.
This is an ongoing issue impacting our lunch menu every day. Check the district website for updated information.
Some of you have heard the possible changes to finals. Well, we have some answers. Ms. Palace says the finals weights may be changed and it could stay the same. Ms. Palace, one of the SBDM members, said the issue was for the board to decide. Although, after questioning the board member, Kelly Walker, she said that the decision was up to the teachers and wasn't aware that this was an issue.
Keep finals the same because it's worked for 4 years and if it's not broke, don't try and fix it.
I think we should decrease test final wages because some students aren't great test takers.
I think that we should decrease the test end of the school year final just because it causes a lot of stress on students and causes them not to have a good end of the school year.
They should decrease the weight of the final tests because not all students have access to study materials.
The Voice is back, live in the auditorium. I am your host, Zach Masick, and if you think you have a chance to be the next champion of The Voice McCracken, please fill out this Google form and submit a video of you singing a 1 to 2 minute song of your choice, due by October 20th at 11 a.m.
The Fall Choir Concert is on October 19th at the Sea Plant Performing Arts Center. Singers need to arrive at 5 p.m. and the performance starts at 6 p.m. The cost is $5, anyone can attend, and masks are required. On October 2nd, our marching band was scheduled for a band competition in Muhlenberg County. Due to the weather, it was canceled. Their next competition is this Saturday, the 16th, in Hopkinsville.
The next SBDM meeting is November 9th. There's a possibility this will go to the board, which meets on October 28th. While our school offers many after-class activities, we would like to talk about one of our more unique ones, the Yo-Yo Club. They accept all members no matter their skill level and will even provide yo-yos for you to use. The members try to meet at least once a week with no set schedule. If you're interested, contact Mr. Basil or join the club's Remind code using the code on screen.
Homecoming is tomorrow and starts at 8 o'clock. Do not come early because the band will be unloading and it will cause problems.
Here are a few things you need to know before you go.
Now this is the House 4 parking lot, right? The one we're supposed to be in?
Yeah, Dad, this is the House 4 parking lot. Okay, we're good.
Do y'all have the money to get in?
I have $5 for each of us.
It's gonna be really cold. Y'all need anything to cover up?
Yeah, Dad, I'll just give her my jacket or something.
I'll be here to pick you up at 11, right when the dance ends.
All right, Dad.
Love you guys. See you later.
And hey, remember kids, the trees have eyes. Don't do anything you wouldn't want your grandma to see.
It took multiple penalty kicks after a double overtime, but our boys soccer team is regional champions for the second straight year. They played Marshall County Wednesday night. The game ended in a 1-1 tie thanks to a goal from Ethan Roberts. They'll play again in the first round of sub-state on October 18th or 19th. Josh Kuntz and Hayden Stewart were selected the all-region team. Meanwhile, the girls' soccer team ended their season as district champions once again. Tuesday night, their season ended with a loss to Graves County in the regional tournament's first round. The state golf tournament happened over fall break at the Bowling Green Country Club, and we had a great turnout. Special congrats to Madison Glisson and her 13th place finish. Madison with a score of 78 and Sophie with a score of 82 both made the cut to play in the second round of the tournament. Also, congratulations to Abe Dumas on making the cut with a 78, his first time at the state tournament. The MCHS football team lost over fall break, losing 41-0 to South Warren on October 8th. This is the team's bye week, so they do not play tonight. They'll play again next week. Archery will be starting October 27th at the Routon Tennis Center at 4 p.m. Anyone interested in joining the team can come and try out. All equipment is provided. You must have a sports physical and a pair of closed-toed shoes to participate. If you have any questions, you can email Coach Simmons or you can join the Remind Group at Mustang Art.
Pinky!
Oh, hey. Didn't see you there, Mustangs. Anyway, you may know the House principals. They're all awesome. But they're also pretty scrappy if you didn't know. And I'd like to see who'd win an arm wrestling match because the school wouldn't let me just let them have a full on fighting match. So let's just see how this goes. We're going to go ask questions. Out of all the House principals, who'd win an arm wrestling fight?
I think Mr. Jackson would. He's a pretty big guy.
All right. Nathan, out of all the people, who do you think would win an arm wrestling fight out of all the House principals?
I'd probably go with Mr. Jackson too.
Mr. Jackson, that's my choice. All right, Noah, what about you?
What about me?
Yeah.
What's the question?
Out of all the House principals, who'd win an arm wrestling fight?
Me.
Me? All right.
Jack. What did you say, Mr. Jackson? Yeah, whatever you said.
What about you?
I don't even know any House principals. I'm going to say Jackson, though.
You?
Definitely Jackson.
I would say probably Jackson, even though, yeah, if it wasn't for the school, I would think he's a retired wrestler.
I love that guy. All right, Mr. Hunter.
Ooh, I love.
I'll take Jackson.
Take Jackson? This whole table went for Jackson, dude.
Dobson, yeah.
Dobson for sure.
Yeah, I got
bro.
Dobson. Money's Dobson. On
Dobson. Dobson. All right. Hey, Jason, so out of all the House principals, who'd win an arm wrestling fight?
Honestly, House 1's going to win.
What about you, Alec?
I don't know.
What about you?
I don't know.
Here we go.
Jackson.
That's what everyone said. Yuki.
Jackson.
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Come on.
Mr. Dobson.
Gotcha.
Oh, Miss Woods, for sure.
Miss Woods? I thought so.
I only know one, and it's Mr. Dobson. He scares me.
I guess Dobson.
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 If it was still Mr. Hauser, if he was still one of the House principals, I'd say him.
Really?
But I'd say Miss Chapman, just because
really?
She's my House principal.
Gotcha. Yeah. Bias.
All right.
I'd say Dobson.
Dobson?
Yeah. Dobson?
Yeah, Dobson. A lot of people said that. All right, thanks. Make sure you stay tuned into next week to see the House principals actually wrestle for an autographed picture of me, Gage Lawrence.
Thank you for watching another episode of Mustang TV News.
You can watch this episode and every episode on our YouTube channel. Just search up McCracken Media Classes.
And remember, everyone matters and every moment counts.